outside the bookshop, we had our second-hand bookshop. We had Dick outside. We had our first program.
could imagine my sister, she loves bumpy rides, and something like this she would just love.
Oh, I love it too.
Yeah. My younger sister, she would just love it.
The public preferred to all four-wheel trams when they were still, the really old-fashioned ones were still running.
Our next tram to run is at the bottom of the hour, 1:30.
No cordless telephones that had cameras on it. Had film cameras on them, but. No cordless telephones with film cameras back then. Now you must wave. You must wave at the people. The old tramway museum was inside there. That's where it used to be, just inside of there. The old tramway museum that ran from 1965 till, I think it was around 1988, which is when they relocated to where we are now. Unfortunately, the old museum burnt down back, I think it was 2017, sometime around there, due to arsonists. But over there, I can point it out on the way back, there's an old platform there, Scouts Camp. be exiting from the other side. And here's the old train platform here, Royal National Park. And by the end, there was only one platform. But there was about four platforms on here. Another set of tracks over there, and another set of platforms over there. You can still find some remnants of them.
End of the line.
This is the old platform just along here. This used to be a huge station, four platforms. By the time that it shut down, only that one little platform there remained. And it's the only one still in use by the Sydney Tramway Museum. Everything else is, well, under here. And here we go, this is where the other platform would have ended here, and they went and filled all this here, and this is where the end of the platform was, the bricks just along there. And then this is the shelter that they built in the 70s. There were more proper stuff earlier, back before cars were common, and had those rich cars that you could see earlier. This bench is dodgy at best.
Oh look, free wood!
No.
I wasn't actually going to take it back in.
Buy wood, go to Bunnings.
I did buy wood yesterday, Matthew.
Oh, okay then.
When I was buying plants for a garden,
This is great. This is a accessible bushwalk. That might kill you, but this is an accessible bushwalk. And I'm happy. I can walk along here without having to worry about falling off cliffs.
Accessible cliffs. Bushwalk, very good, yes. Very good.
I forced him to say that.
You did not.
Really robs me of opportunities for social media posts where I can have family reunions. And I don't do it out of respect for you, but I would.
Sorry, I shouldn't be listening.
Joshua, my brother.
Yeah.
He is basically a skinny one.
half the innies.
Oh, and it's funny because Matthew is currently in New Zealand, as you know, yeah. And he's got his own Kiwi doppelganger.
Oh, hey.
Yeah, look, I put it up. So this is Matthew, and then there's.
Yeah.
Don't you see the similarity?
Well, we wouldn't have to.
We have self-recovery chairs.
Mm, I know, but
like the F35, the self-recovery chair.
Well, we'll have to get two of them if we want to represent accurate preservation.
Yeah, they'll be certified for it.
I think it's